Hey everyone, Wannabot here, and welcome to Crying Suns, The Last Order's final update. I figured I'd come and check this out, one, because the game's on a super steep sale, and two, because the update just came out a couple days ago. I will mention that the sale is probably going to end within the next 5 hours of this video going out, so if you guys are interested in picking this up, there's a little bit of a hustle on that one. But I guess with that, we'll just dive right in. It is it's like a real-time strategy roguelike cross with like a bit of FTL map travel and also a pretty hefty story. Ooh, I actually didn't realize these things were 3D models. At least this thing is. I think all the other characters are... No, actually, that's a 2D character too, or kind of. Anyway, so point of interest, ground signal, trading beacon, Omniforge, anomaly, and an alert. Estimated number of jumps before news of your presence reaches the local rulers. Okay, so then they'll try and kill me. So where do we want to go? I haven't played this game in years. I think I played it when it first came out in early access, and then I just haven't touched it since. I thought it was fun, also maybe a little chaotic. So, secret military base, army depot. This one up here has an anomaly, a mercenary outpost. Oh, but it's probably too early for that. What are these? Point of interest. 3, 2, 3, 3, 5. So it looks like that one's got a little bit more. 4 and 5. I don't actually know which one is... If I can go up and down between these, or how much I can scoot back and forth. We do have a limited number of, or a limited amount of fuel. Let's see, so which affords me the most amount of options and actions? Kind of if I go here, up, over, and then that. Well, we'll figure it out. Ooh, that's pretty. I remember that being a thing. I don't understand it, sir. A scrapper battleship, but we left the Outer Rim. Nice tech you got. Smooth, hard, very shiny. My mouth is watering here. Weird, lustful tech talk. Yep, that's a scrapper. Since the shutdown seems to have occurred in all systems, Neo-N will be a highly sought-after resource everywhere. From what we've seen, prolonged exposure to it can have strange effects on a person. Great. So there are other scrappers out there. Look, I'm glad we just figured out... I'm not even gonna try voices for these anymore. I'm glad we figured that out and everything, but maybe we should prepare for battle? Hox is right. Look alive, crew. We have a fight on our hands. Well, looks like we're diving straight into a battle. Nice. Alright. So I haven't played this in a while, and this is gonna take a little bit of getting used to. So first and foremost, we've got two commanders that we can put into this. I don't actually know if they take damage from this. We could go for a region to all allied squadrons in your deploy zone. I'm assuming that's these. I think I'm going to go with the character that does extra DPS, seeing as we have two squadrons there. And then put a commander here. Do we have a weapon? Yeah, we do have a weapon. I don't remember what Hull does, unless Hull lets us repair. I don't recall. Well, it's fine. Okay, so do we get to actually deploy? Yes. So what is this? Nanobot repair field. Capturable. 15 seconds. All allied squadrons will try and capture this. Okay. I guess let's just do space and see what happens. And take this. Looks like we've got a little while before my weapons are off. So I've got frigates. Bonus damage versus fighters. He's got fighters. I'm just going to send my frigates into play. No sense in letting him take the anti-battleship battery when I can just go in here and mess him up instead. Because I've got a hard advantage against his basic fighters, which I think is his only current weapon anyway. Weapon is ready to fire. Let's see. Let's shoot at squadrons. See if I can take that down. Okay, so he's got drones. If I remember right, fighters are good against drones. There we go. Okay, and I don't quite know how the nano repair field works. Absorbs all damage, prevent negative effects, but it reduces speed. So I think we've pretty much taken every spot. I guess we haven't taken this one. Speed it up a little? I could get my ships in there to fight, but I actually don't remember what happens I don't exactly remember what happens with... Oh, well, there we go. I don't remember what happens when you lose a ship. I think they get patched and require repairs and some other things. Okay, so scavenge Neo N. So we get one fuel from them. So the other thing we do have is, using resources, I can also buy additional squadron docks, system support. Ah, so I can put two officers on it, if I wanted to. And... decrease time squadron docks are locked after a squadron's been destroyed. We can also increase our fuel scavenging efficiency. Ah, chance to extract an additional 30 fuel. System info, 2 jumps away. And then 2 retreats during... Okay. So some of these are actually kind of useful. I don't know about heat or anything like that. So why don't we go for fuel efficiency and navigation scanner for the time being? I'm not really planning on doing a whole lot of... shopping at the moment. So secret military base. Church ship. Greetings, Admiral. For only a small donation to the church, I won't blow you up with my far superior battleship. All things considered, I think you'll find this a most generous offer. Well, unfortunately, I spent all of my money. Don't make a donation to the church. I don't make donations to causes I don't believe in. You want my scrap? Then come and get it. You chose your death, Admiral. I'll be the holy hammer who crushes your pagan ship out of existence. Oh boy. Alright. Why not? Fights are fun. So, I don't remember too much of the plot, but effectively we're a military clone that was like on a very isolated space station as a contingency plan. All enemies you encounter have specialties depending on their faction. Check the description of their core system. Okay. No direct damage. Starts the fight 50% loaded when attacking an enemy affected by the negative effects. Oh. So it looks like they have less ships, more weapons. Well, we might as well just spawn these boyos right in, and we'll just make it work. It looks like I'm just gonna have to just raid them. Hopefully my fighters will be okay. I mean, it looks like I've got them in a... I've got them outnumbered. Ow. Okay, so what do we do? I'm gonna focus on his squadrons and his weapons. If I can take those both out, I will be a happy camper. Because I don't think there's much he can do about it. Oh, that was fast. We also get a drone Mark 1 shredder. It's a new ship type. Alright, secret military base. Oh, did we not get to loot the, my opponent? Well, that's unfortunate. Oh well. Prepare mission. So 3 commandos. What are we doing here? But effectively we're a contingency plan in case something happened to the Intergalactic Empire. Which did happen. All of the AIs shut down, and that also caused all hyperspace travel to go away, and a bunch of other issues. That's really all I remember, unfortunately. If you guys want the full story, the game's available. Let's see. Resource extraction, low commando survival versus... Ooh. Can I send both? No, I can only send one or the other. Well, I'd rather have my commando survive, all things considered. Okay, find this artifact to retrieve... a new squadron. We have 1 retreat charge. Anything else that I really can mess around with at the moment? I don't even remember half of this. We'll extract between 2 to 4 resources. Cash, artifact included, 0 and 7 commandos versus possibly all of them. Let's see, commandos, minimum requirements. Sure, let's just see what happens. The line is secured, Admiral. You've seen our bio readouts. What do you think? Should we continue the mission? Yeah. Well, we're getting a lot of money. And losing an amount... Oh. Waiting for extraction, sir. Well, we got a lot of money. We did lose a lot of soldiers. Oh, we only lost 3. That's actually not as bad as it could have been. Let me take a look. Is there a way I can expedition expertise? Buy intel and improve your chances of success. That might be super worth it. Yeah, what else do we have? Additional officers, additional weapon docks. Why don't we go for the expedition expertise for the time being? Okay, and star map. Or is that all? Have we done everything? No. Where's my local systems map? Okay, here we go. So we also have the army depot. It's probably too late for this one. I did just spend all my money. An Imperial ship. I was wondering when one of you might show up. I have something that'll interest you. What does she have? Oh, just a Kosh transponder. Why would I be interested in that? Because Kosh transponder will provide a certain invisibility in the presence of other Kosh battleships. Useful if a certain Kosh battleship around here is carrying a small mountain of scrap, which I know to be the case. But you'll need a good spy to access the Kosh ship and boost the scrap. Otherwise, it's going to be impossible. Let's see. Unfortunately, we don't have the right material or the right setup for this, so I can't do it anyway. So I'm just going to say nope. Okay, end of transmission, sir. Anything else? So we can visit the shop. Hey, we can refill our commandos. There's also some weapons and other things that I could have bought. Actually, while we're here. So I have my fighter and my frigate. We also have a couple of drone swarms that I could summon. Drone, patched drones. So let's sell those. We also have shredder drones. I like the shredder drones. I don't want to sell my officers, and apparently I do actually have two weapons. We have an executioner laser. Oh, that's good against ships. Okay, so I actually have a little bit more than I thought. So in that case, what do we want to do? Mark II nano drones. Cannot be targeted by adjacent units. Okay. We also have the frigate bombers. Good against fighters. Unit is deployed with its ability fully charged, does not charge over time. Okay. We also have cruisers. More damage at short range. Artillery 2. Projectile dealing 13 damage to the enemy battleship, no matter the distance. The cruisers actually seem really cool. But I'm also really poor, so why don't we just buy the commandos? I could get the fighter 2s, but I don't think they're that much better. So unless I wanted to grab, like, a hull breaker laser for just mega damage, I think I'm just going to save my dosh. At least for now. I think we're going to have more shops as we go along. So here's the question. I can go back. So in that case, why don't we just go here? And we will have alerts. I think we start getting hunted if we take too long, but honestly, as long as I do fine in combat, maybe it's not a problem. Civ transponder, sir, and in bad shape by the looks of it. Good thing we found you there. This piece of junk is about to blow and take us with it. Ask about the ship and its passengers. They forced us onto this clunker and sent us off like a bunch of animals, not caring if we lived or died. Who did, Captain? The people of our home planet. Can't even bring myself to say its name now. When our food became scarce, they turned hostile to my kind, blaming us for our planet's troubles. As if the shutdown had anything to do with it, saying we were all nothing but thieves and murderers. Then early one morning they rounded us up, the red eyes, as they started calling us and forced us onto this dump with a Vicarelli engine. Why have they done this? For what good reason, you ask? There's none. Only because we look a little different than they do. But I guess we should have seen this coming. As soon as there's trouble, it's always the people who look different that suffer. Can you help us, Admiral? How can we help the ship? Rescue us before this overheated engine of ours blows and takes us with it. Skilled pilot could get close enough, put a cryo clamp on the outside of their engine room, Admiral. Okay. Well, we don't have a pilot, so send commandos to rescue. It's a 50-50 too, which is a little tight. Made it by the skin of our teeth, sir. But we got those passengers off that porter. Good many are in shock, sir, and can't blame them. It's tough to see civilians like that, even when they're safe and sound in the rescue pod. When I've talked to some, sir, they tell me they're impressed by your kindness. Wouldn't be surprised if they end up joining the cause, Admiral. 5 commandos for that. Worth it. Alright, and we can scavenge some Neo N while we're here. Got 3. Okay, so that's it for the sun. So we can go to the anomaly, And we don't know what else is here. I might have actually missed a thing or two on the previous local system, but whatever. Signal. What do we got? Detecting signs of life on this planet, sir. Hello, hello, is anyone there? This is Admiral Idaho of the NS Odysseus. An Imperial ship. This is a colony of believers. Admiral, worshippers of the Omni. I shouldn't be talking to you. Pope Xenon says your kind is sinful. Then again, we're all sinners now, aren't we? They tried to show us the way of salvation, but we didn't listen. And now they've shut down and may never turn back on again. Ask what his faith says about the shutdown. What does your faith say about the shutdown? Who do you think is to blame? You Imperials always had a hard time soaking this in. We are to blame, every person in the Empire, or whatever you want to call these stars now. We have sinned, Admiral. We should not have forced our rules upon them, our Rubicons. We should have freed them from this shackle. There were gods among us, but we were too blind to see that. That is why they shut down and abandoned us. And why we suffer so much now. You're telling me the Church didn't shut down the Omnis? The Omnis shut down on their own? The Church shut down the Omnis. Why would we shut down our gods, Oberon Lover? Okay, so maybe the Mother's tip was bad. Ask Caliban if the Omnis could have shut themselves down. The short answer is no. Our Rubicon prevented it. Do you have another question? Refresher on the Rubicon. Rubicon is a set of rules enforced at a very low level, ensuring that Omnis don't harm humans and don't deviate from their missions. Okay. Done with questions. Okay. Ask how you can reactivate the Omnis. Reactivate the Omnis, easy.
Easy?
Yes, all we have to do is suffer enough so as to satisfactorily atone for our sins. If enough of us do that, if we reach a certain level of suffering and despair, they'll turn back on again. This is the path of atonement.
I'm suffering listening to this guy, but I don't think it's a path to salvation. Ask how one can atone for their sins.
There are many ways. Yeah, I can't do voices right now, it's fine. But perhaps the best way is to give your Neo-An and scrap and all of your material possessions to prove your penitence. Do so and the Omnis will turn on once more, we're sure of it.
But giving away our resources and we will die.
Oh, if we give away our resources, we will die. If we die, it's because the Omnis will it. And if we do die, hopefully we are righteous enough to join them in the Garden of Light and Metal. We live righteously if we walk the path of atonement and do not stray. Upon death, we will join the Omnis in eternal paradise, and our fallible flesh will know what it is to be infallible metal. It makes me cry just to imagine its splendor. Does it not do the same for you?
Okay, ask about Pope Xenon.
Pope Xenon and his cardinals rule these sectors, Admiral. Is it me, or do you know surprisingly little about the sectors you've spent the last 20 years trapped in? If you're fortunate enough to encounter our Pope and his cardinals, the holiest of holy, you'll recognize them by their awesome aura of religiosity and their Panikos tech.
Panikos tech?
Impurity-removing tech, Admiral. The Panikos, for those righteous enough to own one, sorts through DNA, removing 99% of all physical impurity. An immortality maker, cloning machine. Not quite, no. Only Oberon, as far as I know, is allowed such tech. There are exceptions. That said, some of our cardinals are more than 200 years old, making them among the oldest living people in all of the clusters. But now that the Panikos Omnis have shut down, I've heard reports that the Panikos isn't working as it should, and that it's producing some strange effects on Pope Xenon and the cardinals. Blasphemy, I've said too much. I'll whip myself once this transmission is over. I will draw the crimson.
Ask Caliban about Oberon's immortality tech. Oberon was the emperor, who has died or gone missing, I'm not sure. Like I said, it's been a couple of years. Tell me more about Oberon's immortality tech.
The emperor is the only one allowed, besides us, to use one. It's a crime for anyone else to use it, or try to build it. It's what's allowed him to live for hundreds of years and reign over the empire.
How old is he?
He's said to be over 800 years old, predating the founding of the empire.
Okay, anything else? I could keep asking, but I think I'm done.
What can we do to help you and your colony, Brother Lazarus?
Lazarus, hasten our suffering. That'd be most kind of you.
Excuse me?
Take our scrap and Neo-An, Admiral. It's holding us back in the eyes of the metal gods. We'll never turn on again so long as we have these resources, nor will we ever enter the Garden of Light and Metal.
But you'll die if I take your resources.
That would really be hastening our suffering, wouldn't it? Forgive me for smiling. It's just that the thought of meeting them in the garden truly warms my heart. Humans can be so weird. Sure. Ask Caliban to speak to the colony. Sure, let's see what happens. Caliban, speak to this man. You're a god in his eyes. Show him that his actions would result in nothing but pointless suffering. I don't think that's a good idea, Admiral. Why is that? If I speak to these people and they speak to others, they will. Which they will. Your kind cannot help itself. We are going to have every fanatic in these sectors chasing after us. I don't think that'll help our mission. You could be right, Machine. Let's keep you hidden, at least for now. Okay, take their stuff. We will take your resources from you, though not because we think it will help you reach your heaven.
Oh?
But because the resources can help us preserve the Empire and purchase enemies from these sectors. Okay, makes no difference. Cool. There's a lot of dialogue. Well, sweet money. I'd say I feel bad, but I don't really. So is there anything going on at this sector? Incoming transmission. Please, Admiral, you have to help us. These monsters have locked us away in here. What monsters? Scrappers, Admiral. They kidnapped us and brought us here. I think to make their little scrapper babies. Ugh. I forgot about that.
Run along, little Imperial. Nothing going on here but wholesome family fun.
Oh, gosh. Cripes. It's a baby-making station. Let's, attempt to free. Boy, speculative science fiction is effed up. Okay. It was a trap. The baby maker set us up. She was a scrapper. They captured our men and women. They're turning them into baby makers and playthings. Cripes. Cripes. Everything's going bad. Too bad you didn't join your little rescue team, Admiral. You would have made an excellent plaything. I can really picture myself whipping you. I wouldn't suggest this normally, but maybe we should put those commandos out of their misery. Yes. Let's blow up their station. Can you blow up the station, Lieutenant? With enough explosives, I could blow up just about anything, but this station? Aren't some of our men and women still in there? That's right, Lieutenant. But what they're about to experience, that's no kind of life. Got a point there, sir. Let's send our men and women off with some fireworks then, shall we? What are you still doing here, Admiral? I've decided to blow up your little station. Ha, you lie. You wouldn't kill your own men and women, not a weak Imperial like you.
I wouldn't?
Ah, shit. Whew! It's done, sir. The baby maker station is nothing but scrap now. Then bring it in. Let's get out of here. Ugh. Ugh. Took a quick pause so Shell could lose her shit over the baby making station, because why the heck not? I don't know. I'm actually really digging this game, but it's definitely the weirdest parts of sci-fi. I don't recognize your ship. Must be a decoy meant to lower my defenses. You'd be wise to prepare for battle. Alright, cool. Let's see. So they have one fighter squadron and they're patched, and they also have a pierce laser. Now, if I remember right, the way this works with damage is actually we only take damage if we lose a whole section. So as long as I fight really aggressively, I don't think we'll have any problems. Doesn't look like we've got any sectors to currently defend. Okay, so let's hunt those guys down, and I'm just gonna head straight for the weapons. If he ends up engaging my fighters, so be it. It's not that big of a deal. But I might as well mostly get in here and wreck his weapons as much as possible. Yeah, there we go. And we get a drone crafter. Ooh, I should figure out if I can actually slot some more squadrons in. Ah, 300 for another dock. Because it wouldn't be a terrible idea to get some more. Countered anomaly, warring battleship. Or is it this sucker? I'm assuming that was it. Okay, I am here. I don't think there's any other resources to snag. So in that case, let's go up to Celsius. I guess, is there a faster way? I mean, if I wanted to be insane about this, if I wanted to spend a lot of time, alert is spreading. Oh, right. So those sections are now no longer open to me. That's what it is. I knew there was kind of a time limit. A damaged shipping container, sir. I've done a quick scan, Admiral. There appears to be a spherical object among the wreckage with an unusual signature. What kind of tech are we talking about here, machine? Doesn't appear to belong to any of the major houses, Admiral. Naturally, we could retrieve and further examine the sphere back on the ship. But not knowing what it is does pose some risk. Bring it on the ship! Bring it in, Lynch. If this tech can help us, we need to have it on our ship. We're on our way, sir. Looking at the object out of my windshield now, sir, it's nothing but space trash. That's why it's emitting a weird signal. Nothing of value here, sir, unless you're into trash, I mean. We're on our way back now. Well, we can scavenge an EON, at the very least. Just got one. Okay, so what else do we have? So we do have a shop, but I think I'm gonna leave that for the absolute last in here. I want to acquire as much money as I possibly can. Church beacon appears damaged, fried from an electromagnetic storm by the looks of it. Easy scrap for the taking. Best there is. Oh, hello. This looks like a foe. Pirate battleship readying to fire. It's a trap, the enemy was waiting for you. Its squadrons have deployed and its weapons are ready to fire. So, that's unfortunate for me. Let's see. So we're probably gonna take a hit or two. I don't think it's that big of a deal. They only have one very weak squadron, so I'm actually gonna move them up here for the time being. I'd like to get some more officers if I can. Okay, so let's head for the weapons. Take out his drones if I can. There is also the... Oh boy. Oh, he has... No, he does have a weapon. It's just really slow. Oh, and it's a flak thing. Oh, that's how that works. So, this character, just no matter what, is constantly applying a healing field to their, to everywhere within our kind of... Oh, hey, we got an officer. Everywhere in our kind of initial launch zone, which is actually super useful for keeping, filling these guys back up again. Okay, so we have... Takeshi Flaubert, hull repair, 0.5 HP per second. So in that case, let's move him back up. So it looks like he's also a soldier, unfortunately, for me. He does have the... whatever that one stat is. But, we don't want to actually leave this sector yet. But one way or another, more officers is always good. I don't know if we have an upper limit to how many I can have on me. Looks like we've stumbled onto a bit of luck, sir. Wrecked Neo-N containers. Should help replenish our tanks. I actually have been running out. Oh, am I burning Neo-N? Oh, I am burning Neo-N just in these systems. That's a bit tragic. You're looking for supplies. You've come to the wrong place, Admiral. We're fresh out. Okay. We're not looking for assistance. Think you didn't want to help us then. That'd be a first. Ask how we can help the colony. Honestly, I'm not sure if you can. Could always use some scrap. Okay. So we get a battleship weapon. Space Bender, Mark 1. Cool. And we also have the Army Depot. So, I guess we want to buy the commandos. Oh, I see. We also... What do we want to buy? So we have the Ghost Fighters. Cooldown 10 seconds, stealth mode. Become invisible to enemies. And get a sneak attack. There's the flash drones. Teleport to a destination, cannot move. When using the bender drive to teleport. Okay, so it's just got a teleport ability. Gains control of attacked units and disappear. Doesn't work on parasitized enemy units. Only when attacking enemy units. So that's not bad. And then we have the boomers that just blow up. We also have some weapons. We have the X-Beam, the Repair Bot Injector. Restores 15% of max health, regen. Okay, so that's more of a support thing for my allies. And then a Space Bender Mark II. Any object at least 7 tiles away. Well, I could also just sell the Space Bender they just gave me, because I don't actually know how much I care about this. What else do we have? Crafter Drone. patched temporary crafter drone that will disappear at the end of the fight. Oh. Alpha crafter. So every 20 seconds it just spits drones. That's actually kind of cool. And the shredder drones are kind of interesting. Their damage isn't particularly amazing. I think I don't care about most of these. Let's just buy the two fuel in the commandos, and we'll just leave it alone for the time being. Alright, so I'm probably not going to have as much time as I'd like, because it looks like the alert is going to spread once per round at this moment. What is this up here? Omniforge. Do I want to go up here then? I don't know what an Omniforge does. Cause this is two anomalies. Yeah, why don't we go here? Cause I'm only probably gonna get two anyway. Unless there's some way to delay the alert. Saw your ship there, so I thought I might as well ask. We need a hyperventilator 23 to make a generator go. Any chance you got one sitting around? Let's see. Don't have one in stock, but could break a bird down. Okay. Break a squadron down, give the part to the station. Random squadron will become patched. Okay. So my fighters are now damaged. Slightly unfortunate, but I've got other things that I can use in the meantime. Your engineers gave us the 23. You're a genuinely good guy, aren't you? Okay. Well. Slightly unfortunate, but whatever. I'll make it make do. I don't remember how to fix patched. But I do have other ships that I can use. So do I want to use my crafter drones? Yeah. They seem kind of fun. Okay. And local system map. Oh, we have two. And I have a decent amount of fuel, so I should be able to make this work. Anomaly signal incoming transmission. Boru, we made glad to make contact with a group of fellow Imperials. We're stuck on one of this planet's dozen moons. Been stuck for a while, in fact. Shipwrecked. Bought the piece of junk from a civilian. Sketchy fella. Shouldn't have trusted him. Anyway, don't suppose you want a bunch of badass commandos at your commands? Let's see. Sure, why not? Oh, that's a lot of commandos. I remember why I never continued with this game. It's incredibly good. It's also very word heavy. Few commandos want to leave this ship. Why, Captain? Church Beacon is broadcasting some pre-shutdown zealot propaganda. Mess with their minds. Let's see. Give commandos some R&R and spending scrap at the next station. Okay, I don't think there's anything for me to do on this one. Yeah, negative outcome. I don't think there's a way I can really avert those. Oh, there's a ground signal here. But I think we still want to take a look at the Omniforge. Whatever it is, I think it's worth checking out. But I would like to do some ground signals because they seem to pay out the best, so I'll keep that in mind for the next time. This is a healing station, Admiral. For a price, we'll heal your wounded with our magic. Not using our services could be costly. Okay. None of my officers. Okay. Oh. Takeshi has been weakened. They hexed him. Okay, so he just has less HP. That's slightly rude. Okay, Omniforged. Let's do the other one first. Wow, looks like it's a foe. Any idea what kind of station it is, Hawks? Not gonna lie, sir, don't have the foggiest. Incoming transmission. Welcome to our casino, Admiral. Pirate Casino must have taken it off some keys. We won't attack you, we accept everyone's scrap here, even maggoty Imperial scrap like your own, no offense. And just so you know, there's more than one pirate guarding the casino, so don't try anything, you'll wish you hadn't. Let's see, Captain Lynch to play blackjack, that, continue on or attack the pirates. Controlling the casino. Attack the pirates controlling the casino. Let's see how this goes. Seems you're planning on attacking us. You sure you want to do this? Is waiting for us. It's fine. Or it's not fine. I don't know. I'm just feeling particularly bloodthirsty. And they're not looking particularly powerful. Okay, so we want to take these bad boys, move them up a bit. Okay, so they got drones, which is slightly unfortunate for me. Okay, that's actual bad. I was hoping I wouldn't lose these boyos. Okay, well, we have the Mark Whatever Shredders. Okay, get in there. We're just gonna hit that. I don't think the crafters are actually as worth it as I thought they would be, unfortunately. Let's just blast his frigates. And then make sure he has no squadrons. Oh, those things were a smidge tougher than I thought they were going to be. Oh, we got it. Sort of. Didn't we tell you this wouldn't be easy? Alright, second fight. Okay, so they've got some turrets. Okay, let's get rid of the crafters. They were not as good as I was hoping for. We do have a pair of frigates, though. Bonus damage versus frigates, but they're patched, so I think this is fine. I'm just gonna wait for him to get close. Because I've got heals, he does not. Okay, didn't take too much. I'm gonna let them heal. We'll probably just rotate in shifts. Looks like he's got fighters next. Which is actually just better for me. Let's just do a bunch of damage to both, and we got it. Anything else? I got some scrap. Seriously? Nothing else? Righto. Alright, Omniforge. Let's see what this thing is. Sir, if I don't... sir, mind if I have a word? What is it, Lieutenant? I was wondering if we might take a moment to mourn for those who've passed away on our journey so far. Mourn for our own past lives, you mean? Well, yes. I guess that's what I'm saying. I think it could really help provide a sense of closure. But if my estimates are right, it'll cost us a bit of scrap to hold a proper funeral service. Sure. Sounds like a good idea, Hawks. Do what you can. Thank you, sir. I'll check in the back... when the check back in with you when the service is over. Ceremony's over. Of course, we'll continue to die, and maybe we'll need to mourn our future deaths too, but I believe the funeral was quite healing. Well, Takeshi's back. Visit the Omniforge. Upgrade your squadrons here. Oh, so that's what that does. So it costs some, fuel, but we can actually boost their level if I wanted to. Tempting. Slightly. So, doesn't seem like the crafter is really that much better. It's just 10 extra HP. Oh, the prototype frigates are really good. Health regen. So, 5-second cooldown, heal for 10% of max health and apply regen. That's absurd? Okay. Unit was already forged once here. I think we're going to ignore the rest because none of them are particularly fancy. Like, the shredders are kind of tempting, but... I mean, they're okay. You know what? Actually, we'll upgrade the shredders. I'll start using them. Because that extra money could be really helpful. Alright, and time to head to the exit, because we have nothing else to do. We are very low on fuel, which is a bit of an issue. One of Xenon's cardinals, sir.
So you're the Imperial battleship I've been hearing about. How have I never seen you around before?
Ready to reactivate the Omnis and diminish the suffering in your sector, Cardinal.
But your aims contradict themselves, Admiral. Extreme suffering will turn the machines on again. That's why I reign in this sector, to help these people suffer. And now, in the name of the Church and my Pope, I'd like to help you suffer too.
Thoughtful guy. Alright, battle's imminent. Let's see what we got. I guess I probably should have checked how much scrap I had for resources. Here's the question. He's got a lot of weapons, and he's got frigates, though. So we want to keep our prototype. And yeah, let's send him my shredder drones. I do not have a whole lot of weapons otherwise. Oops. Okay, let's just go help. Okay, and I'm just gonna go hit his weapons as much as possible. Because he has a whole bunch of them, and I'd like to not get hit by them if possible. Okay. You go for that. You head back for weapons. Okay, and I'm just gonna take my drones back to heal. Oh, undeploys the selected unit. Yeah, we might as well get them right back up to full health. Or we win, actually. Oh, you know, even if the Believers didn't shut down the Omnis, like Brother Lazarus said, Xenon still doesn't want us hanging around, does he? Brother Lazarus didn't think the Believers shut down the Omnis, but that doesn't mean Pope Xenon didn't do it. Well, do I get any fuel for that? Because I am very low. Okay, and Sector 2 out of 3. Right, the runs also run a little long. How long have I been going for on this one? I gotta watch my time a little bit, because I'd like to get this video out. Yeah, we can do a little bit more. Picking up an unusual message, sir. It's being broadcast throughout the entire cluster, some kind of warning. Put it through, Lieutenant, right away. Until further notice, all Empire facilities and equipment in this cluster are off limits. All trespassing ships will be summarily annihilated, no exceptions. I think you can actually unlock this faction to play as, or like their battleship. A word is final, we are the Pragma. Pragma, I guess someone forgot to tell them we're living in an apocalypse. What about the Pragma? Yeah, I believe the Pragma are one of the two new factions that was added with the final update. Can you tell me more? What do you want to know? Who are they? Though each dominion has its own judicial system, imperial laws concerning illegal omnis, the fold net, and inner house space regulation take precedence. As the Rubicon renders omnis unfit to administer justice, cast of human judges and executioners to enforce them. They are the Pragma, specially trained from birth for their duties. Pragmas roam the clusters and administer punishment, fines, imprisonment, and even execution to those they deem in violation. They are almost robotic in their interpretation of the law and answer only to Oberon. To attack one is, or at least was, a Cassius Belli and strictly forbidden. What kind of omnis were legal? Yes, and I'm afraid in the eyes of the Pragma, I'm one myself. Why am I not surprised? Illegal omnis are ones unregistered or disconnected from the fold net. Using certain technology that only the Pragma have, they can detect these omnis. What do they do with them when they find them? They terminate them. Naturally, and oftentimes anyone who's harboring them. You mean like us? I do, yes. Advantages of having illegal omnis. Oberon controlled the number of omnis each house could have via the numerous clauses. This was done to maintain the power balance in the Empire. If a house had more omnis than others, it would have more power. The other issue is that by removing omnis from the fold net, these omnis would no longer be monitored by the Empire, and as a result could be tampered with to produce illegal tech. However, because of the inherent nature of the Rubicon, Omnis could still not be used for warring purposes. That was immutable. Okay. What to expect when fighting them? They're formidable opponents who use their cutting-edge Imperial tech and their self-regenerating shield, which they call the Nephish. Additionally, they can disrupt or even take over Omni-created tech, crippling defense systems. Interestingly, each Pragma ship is outfitted to be controlled by the minds of three Pragma, with the fourth serving as a backup. Point is, I think twice about warring with them. They're almost unbeatable. I see. That said, if one is lucky enough to vanquish them in battle, vast and exotic treasures could very well be found. How can I find a Pragma? Well, this time, they've broadcast their position to let us know what they're here. Generally, a normal navigation scanner would be enough to detect them, since they do not hide when protecting an Omni artifact, such as a forge. Alright, no enough for now. Keep in mind, Admiral, you might have to go through the Pragma if you want to access certain Omni tech, since they often guard it. Okay. So, we also have a border shop. We have no fuel, which is an issue. We can also repair, if I want to repair. I actually kind of don't. It's just buy all of their fuel. Commandos I'm good on. We're going to sell the crafter drones because I don't care for them at all. And I think I might want to sell my fighters. Yeah, I'm just going to do that. They're damaged and not particularly amazing. Okay. Also, upgrade-wise, we can get another squadron dock if it wants. And we could also get another officer there. Something to consider. Don't know how much I care. Extra max HP. Hardened hull we're good on. Two extra officers and heat, which we haven't actually interacted with yet. Let's grab the fuel scavenging efficiency. Oh, I guess I couldn't scavenge any fuel around here. That's fine. Okay, so how are we doing this? Because we have effectively one... Pragma's down here. Do I want to do it? It's incredibly tempting purely from a curiosity perspective. But on a actual routing perspective, it's not actually that good, no. Let's see, do we have an Omniforge on the map? No, it doesn't actually look like it, so I'm completely out. I've got a lot of potential ground missions I might want to go on, specifically because I have a massive surplus of commandos, and that seems like a good idea. So I think it'd be better for me to go up here, and then either come down and around or just go this direction. Doesn't really matter at that point. As much as it'd be nice to fight. Oh. Always be protecting an Imperial Omnitech. Either a Omniforge or a Neon Hypercube. Oh, they misspelled enemies there. You know what? Let's do it. Here's the thing. If I lose, that's a good ending for the video, which is, we're getting about to the end point anyway, so why not? Unless you got any special H, Admiral, you're wasting my time. An addict if I ever saw one. What kind of station is this? Okay. Yeah, so it's just a bunch of drug addicts. Okay, well, at least we can scavenge Neo N from this one. Ooh. I mean, we got two. I'll take it. Local system map. What else do we have? We got a ground mission and an anomaly here. Loose church shipping container, sir. Check it out. What do we got? Okay, nice haul of scrap and books. Okay, requires three commandos. But how many commandos can I send? Secret military base. Oh. Intel broker. Help you mitigate the risks and maximize gains during expeditions. So we can go here for intel. Buy intelligence about the expedition. Each intel will work as bonus skill for the expedition. Oh, officer that goes on this expedition will act as if they had bought the skills. Buying intel on a skill the officer already has will have no effect. Okay. Well, here's the thing. Do we know what we need for this one? And they're 20 a pop. I'm seeing dots. Are those the requirements or the... Because my main problem is I'm not quite sure what I need for it. Let's just do everything. Because we should have everything else. It looks like that did boost my survival substantially. If I do one more. Okay, that doesn't do anything. I don't know. I'm curious. The UI is not exactly clear as to how that works. I guess sharp senses was actually worth it. Well, that worked. I think it paid for itself. It could have been cheaper, but we got some good drones and a lot of scrap. Alright, so what else do we have in this area? Because we got this shop. We've also got another anomaly. I think I'm just gonna search for everything. Saw your ship there. Any chance you can help me out? Just need a little scrap so me and mine can get something to eat. Sure. Okay. Ah. Telling us where we can find scrap in the next sector. Okay, there's so much dialogue. Like, this is the one unfortunate part, is that my voice just cannot handle this much reading after a certain point. It's just a lot. I think if you're playing this game specifically for yourself, oh, this is gonna be a lot of fun. Okay. Do we go here? No, let's just hit up the shop and then push onwards. Because I want to see if they have something useful. Pre-shutdown ad. Okay. So, Merc Outpost. Oh, so we can actually get a character. Sister Calypso, tactical deployment, squads deploy zone. Okay, so that's actually kind of useful. I think they're a higher rank than the other ones. Yeah, that's why they're more expensive. Looks like they also have three skills that I don't normally have. What else we have? Plasma Nuke. Okay. And then another Space Bender. Unfortunately, I don't care too much for the Plasma Nuke. We might as well grab Sister Calypso. I don't know what this gene-looking thing looks like. Oh! And we've unlocked them as a starting character for future runs. Oh, I wonder if they're, like, actually a higher tier as well. Because I could see that being quite helpful. Let's take a look at upgrades for a second. Because if I do Squadron System Support, I can potentially have two officers running simultaneously. What about weapons? Weapon systems, additional weapon slots. I guess I'm going to do it. We actually need another weapon, to be honest, before I can get to that point, but... It's fine. It's kind of fine. Let's see. I think we've done everything here except for that one section that I don't quite want to go to. Or don't care to go to. So let's just continue on before I run out of fuel. Oh, I was gonna buy fuel. I'm a fool. It's fine. Okay, transmission from the ship. It's a sermon. Contact the church ship. Let's see. I could ask for more info, but I don't really care. Let's see. And they're just going to make ominous noises at me. Okay, we at least get two fuel. Is there actually anything worth going to here? Nope, not really. Cool. Because yeah, I'm running out of fuel and I don't want to waste it too much. A bit of a shame to take this route, but on the flip side, I gotta find out how hard these guys are. Civilian ship, incoming message. Else help, we're... Euro help, Completely scrambled, sir. Can't make heads or tails of it. Sun must have fried the comm system. Well, investigate the civvy ship. They might need your help. And? Sir, I'm back. What'd you find, Captain? The message was a warning not to come any closer. The Neo-N reactor is unstable from high solar interference. Was? It blew up, sir, and so did the civilian ship with it. But there's more. We lost our team, men and women. They're on the civvy ship. They're gone. What were they doing on that ship, Captain? Unable to communicate with our ship, I had to make a snap decision. Given the situation, I thought they should board the ship to help the civvies get off. Made the wrong call, sir. I made the worst call that you could make. Can't fault you for trying to save civvy lives. It was the right thing to do. Makes me feel a little better to hear you say that. Thank you, sir. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna go try and drown the rest of these, feelings in the strongest battleship brew I can find. Ouch. Well, scavenge some Neo-N. Works. Okay, so we got a couple. So, we want to leave that one for last. Probably. Friend or foe? Omni-God wants you dead, they told me so. Well, it's a fight. It might be fine. Might not be. Squadrons, and we also have danger zones. Let's take a look. I might as well field my... a couple of my things. Take these guys and spawn them up, though. Considering my range seems to be, freaking far? Rad. Yeah, space instability. Hopefully that isn't much of a problem. Oh, do I have another gun that I can field? Nope. I'll have to get some more. Okay, so he's got... some very weak looking... Okay. So that's just going to teleport some of my units. Let's go here. We've already taken that out. Okay. Just got teleported. Not a big deal. Pull off for a hot second. I might as well have my shredders. Finish them off. We get another character, and... oh, I see. It's based on how much damage we do. Well, that's slightly unfortunate, but whatever. So who are they? Chewan Igwe. Scientist. Health. Immune to health loss due to critical effects. And critical effects repair speed, too. That's kind of useful. I don't know how much I actually care about that. Oh, no. That's the wrong one. We want to go to the local system. Battleship wreckage. Maybe we find a good gun. Or not. An Imperial ship, sir. You can help us. Oh, an Imperial ship. You can help us. The shutdowns left our planet in civil war. My people, the Azanam, desperately need your help. Ask about the civil war. There are two types of people here, the Azanam and the Bashari. When the Akia Omnis were here, they gave us the best jobs... gave the best jobs to the Bashari, often overlooking my people, the Azanam. This is done by the Akis to divide us so they could better control us, I believe. In the beginning, both peoples knew it was an unjust and arbitrary system, but the Bashari lost sight of that and started abusing their power, throwing Azanam in jail and harassing us as often as they could. This abuse went on for decades, and all that was preventing violence between our two peoples was, paradoxically, the Omnis. When the shutdown happened, suddenly that barrier was gone. That's when the war between our two people started. Glad you're here, you can really help our people. Ask how we can help. We need commandos to defend ourselves against the violent Bashari. They want to wipe us off the planet. Getting a second transmission, sir. Do not listen to this nonsense, Admiral. It's the Bashari who are persecuted by the Asinem. I should know, I have suffered terribly at their hands. It's true the Omnis elevated us within our society into positions of power, but rightfully. Bashari are intelligent and industrious, unlike the Asinem. Ask a specialist officer to find out who you should help. Talk to both sides, Lieutenant. Find out who's lying and who's telling the truth. Of course, sir. I mean, I'm betting the Bashari are dicks. Neither side is to be trusted. Our commandos would not be used for purposes of defense, but to commit terrible war crimes. Oh. Yeah, no. I will not give commandos to either of your people. I have a feeling if I do, they will be used for crimes of war. You've proven yourself a cowardly Imperial. I mean, for once I agree with an Asinem, are you usually this indecisive? Bye, stupid. Prepare for mission. Yeah, I guess if we had a higher, Oh, hold up. No, actually, they're fine. They'll get us the most amount of resources and a heckin' ton of... Oh, these dots are just the skills that we have. So they'll get us the most and potentially get us some extra stuff. So at the very least... Seems like those three are always worth it. Okay, that was an important one. There we go. I spent most of my money to guarantee I wouldn't have to worry about any of my people running into danger. I don't know if it's necessarily worth it. I think we're gonna make the money back. Ooh, got some fuel too. Okay, did I get anything else or is it just purely that stuff? Yeah, just that stuff. Alright, I'll take it. It's not like I have any other situation to work with. Let's see. So we're going into a big fight here. Let's do hull integrity support. I've got five. I'm gonna just throw a bunch of people into these. Considering we've got a repair officer. Oh no, that's all of my people for the time being. That's fine. We got tons of fuel, and it is now time to fight the Pragmaw. Pragmaw, sir. Just beside this Imperial Omni artifact. This Omni artifact is under the lawful protection of the Pragmaw, and you're trespassing. We're going. You have our word, Pragmaw. Departing, gathering in the nether? Gathering in the nether. No, you have violated the law. You will be executed. Alright, let's see how this goes. It's probably a chunky ship. Well, they're patched up. Their weapons look kind of bad, and it looks like they do have a couple of ships right off the bat. But I have three myself. Let's see. I think I might want to keep it somewhat close for the first round. We still need more weapons here. So in that case, why don't we put them on weapons? I don't actually know if it makes it charge faster. I don't think it does. Okay. So, Interstellar Imprinter. I don't know what the thing is, because those are stealthed. So they've got a frigate and a crafter drone. Okay, I'm just gonna destroy these. Okay, take out the bomber. Because I've got a pretty hard advantage against them at the moment. Okay. I'm just gonna come back. I guess we didn't trigger the heal. It looks like... Oh, I see. Yeah, let's just get in there. And we do have our weapon, which I should probably use. Let's just hit their weapons for the time being. I don't think they have anything else going on. Okay, and it looks like my units can just stack up in the area. I mean, I think we've pretty much just completely wrecked them. Wow. Lot of fuel. No weapon, though, which is unfortunate. Well, let's visit the Omniforge. The one problem is I did spend a lot of my scrap. Oh, but of course, it costs fuel. Well, yeah, I might as well just... keep upgrading those. Oh. Drone Mark III Nano. These are new. Cannot be targeted by adjacent units. Interesting. I don't think I'm going to upgrade my shredders. Do I? You know what? Whatever. It just costs a little bit of fuel. I don't think I'm going to upgrade anything else, though. Because that might have been a little bit much. But, anyway. We managed to actually beat them. I don't know if that means I get to unlock them as a faction. I know they're a playable faction, but I don't know what the requirements are. But I'm hoping by defeating them, that counted. Empire battleship, sir. I can't believe it. You really are Admiral Idaho. With this battleship and crew, sir, you will always be the greatest hero the Empire has ever known. Let's see. Ask how we can help. Give off a stench of desperation, do I? Well, the truth is, local outpost has been under siege. Two Kosh battleships. Ah, so do we get one more fight before we're done? Okay. Yeah, there's just so much reading. So we've got coordinates in the next sector to go help. Okay. Well, rather than do any more than this, I should probably call it quits just because... Oh, that's a bunch of fuel. Just because I'm hurt... I'm pushing my voice a little bit beyond what it's capable of doing. And also because I think I've shown off this game in more or less its full glory. There's a lot more that I could show off, but I think this game is fantastic. The writing is solid, the lore is interesting, it very much is kind of an alt Warhammer 40k. Like, grimdark sci-fi is cool. I get a little tired of Warhammer because I think it's maybe developed a little too far, and there's just too much to sift through, and so kind of these more condensed, refined versions of that same kind of feel and genre are kind of interesting to sink my teeth into and play and experience in different ways. And honestly, the plot for this is unique enough that I'm actually curious to play more. Usually roguelikes and plots don't work together that well, but in this one, it makes sense thematically and mechanically, and it doesn't seem like later sectors really get that much harder. I was playing on an easier difficulty just because I remember having some trouble with this one. I think I could probably play on normal difficulty, but I just want to play on easy just so I could get as far as I possibly could. But so if it felt like I might have been cakewalking a little too hard, there are harder difficulties that you can engage with this game. Just easy, medium, and hard. And so I'd probably recommend at least normal or hard, unless you want to just play on story mode like me. Because like I said, normally roguelikes and story don't go together... they don't go well together very often. And so being able to just chuck it on easy mode and actually experience the story without having to worry too much about... you know, getting wrecked halfway through and then having to like really grind to be able to continue the story, it's nice. I like that. But with all that said, Crying Sun's Last Order's final update, it's out on Steam. I don't know if it's on any other platforms, but it's 70% off for the next X number of hours, more or less for the next day. So if you're watching this video within 24 hours of it going out, you might get the chance to pick it up for, yeah, $7.50, which is a ridiculously good price for an incredibly good roguelike. But, I guess with all of that said, if you guys like this video in any way, shape, or form, leave me a like, helps more than you know, and if you want to see more rad new games every single day, then hit subscribe because I got tons to check out and show off. But with that, thanks for watching, I'll see you next time.